Hey guys, Matt Allen here with TacticalBassin. We've never done an unboxing video before, but I just got a big order in from Tackle Warehouse. I'm actually getting ready to go out on a smallmouth trip. I'm going to go fish for about a week, chase those bronze backs around, and placed a nice size order before I went. Thought you guys might want to have a look and see what product we're going to be throwing for those guys. Let's pop this box open. Let's see what we got first. Basically, on this trip, I'm going to keep things very, very simple. Going out with some good friends, we're going to be throwing small swim baits, be throwing some underspins. I don't even remember what else is in here, but you're going to get the gist of it. So let's see. First things first, Cool Baits, little tiny underspins, little California company. I ordered a lot of these. We got quite a few of them. Went with two different colors. Big old pile of them. All 3/16 ounce, really, really lightweight. Old Faithful, black, silver are the two colors. But basically it's a little tiny underspin. For the smallmouth, you wanna stay small so that they could fit it in their mouth really well. When I throw the underspin, that little tiny guy is the only way to go. The baits I'm gonna be throwing on that, we've got the 2.8 Keitech. Got, what, 5 packs of those? Little tiny Keitech. They just mate up perfectly to that underspin size-wise. You slow roll that thing, tail's kicking, that underspin's going, just really gets those fish well. Next, we got the 4-inch Keitech Easy Shiners. You know, a lot of the time, I throw that fat swing impact, but sometimes you want to be different. You know, and I think a lot of guys overlook that Easy Shiner, at least where I live, they do. So that 4-inch Easy Shiner, still a small, compact bait, fishes well on a little hook. Went with quite a few of those. Got 2 or 3 colors. Let's see what we got here. Went with Tennessee Shad, of course. Got quite a few packs of Tennessee Shad. And what are these? This is Silver Flash Minnow, more Tennessee Shad, Silver Flash Minnow, just a pile of those. You know, when it comes to smallmouth, you almost can't have too many, right? This looks like piles and piles and piles of Keitechs. Truth be told, if we go out and get on those fish, 2 or 3 days into this trip, we're going to be placing another order, having Tackle Warehouse overnight it to us so we can keep fishing. But this is a really good start. Just going with those really natural bait fish type colors. What else do we have in here? Got my t-shirt because I spent too much money. $150, free shirt. And then some Jackal eye props, of course. Another phenomenal smallmouth bait. We went with Ghost Minnow. Or is that S Ghost Minnow? And HL Wagasaki. Both just dynamite little natural bait fish imitators. Those, if you're not familiar with those, the idea there is take that bait, throw it out, you count it down, and then just super slow creep that handle. Real slow. I really don't give it any action at all. Just barely crawl it. The blades at the front and back of that bait, the bait itself has a little bit of a shimmy to it. Both blades turning at the end. It's a sinking bait. Those fish just come up and cream that thing. Very different look from, say, a jerk bait or a little swim bait or anything like that. So going back to these 2.8 Keitechs, like I said, I pair them up with that little Cool Baits underspin, or I'll put them on my smallest swim bait head, especially that 4-inch Easy Shiner. Of course, I didn't have to order my head. I've got a whole pile of them here, but that Easy Shiner, I generally throw it on a little 1/8 ounce. That's the Matt Allen Swimbait head by Dirty Jigs. Pair that guy up, it's a perfect fit. Just slow roll that thing in the middle of the water column. When it comes to that early pre-spawn, going into the spawn smallmouth fishing, little tiny Keitech, you almost can't beat it. There are some variations, but you get the gist of it. Aside from this, we might be throwing the jerk bait. Who knows, we might even get into a little bit of a topwater bite, but I'm looking forward to the trip. It's going to be a lot of fun. That's it. That's the bottom of the box. Hope that gives you guys some direction if you're out there chasing those brown fish around. We appreciate you watching the videos. Like it. Subscribe to the channel. We'll talk to you soon. First thing is going to be the square bill crankbait. The square bill is a compact bait, fits that general bluegill profile where it's a short, stumpy bait, pretty round. More importantly, it moves very quickly, very erratic, something that bluegill do.
This may be a better day than I think. This lake is starting to look pretty stacked. So we're going to run down lake. I don't know how well you guys can see, but basically, I've got a big point over on this side and an even larger point there on the left, and then the dam down there in the background. And I think I'm gonna focus around those first couple of big points, although I gotta admit this stuff is looking pretty darn good. But we're gonna start out down there. We're gonna focus on some of that stuff and see if we can find some fish on the little bit of structure that is in here.